Hello, Senior Stoner fans. It's the real Senior Stoner back at you for your Honey Badger dab of the day. But today's dab is going to be extreme. We're going to do something called a fingertip dab. But first, we're going to get to the topic of the day. And then we're going to have our Honey Badger fingertip dab. Keep that in mind. You'll be seeing it. Today's topic, fear. What do we fear? Right, what do people fear? Think about it. We all fear similar things, wouldn't you think? Let's discuss. Number one in the hit parade, we fear the unknown more than anything. It's like going into a dark and scary haunted house maze. We don't know what's coming next. The unknown is one of people's fears, truly because it has an element known as loss of control. Think about it. When we don't have control of things, we panic. Many people like to think that we have a handle on our lives, but to some extent only we do. We can pick out a career. We can pick out what we want to eat in early day. But when it comes to the big life events, what will happen next in the future, we really don't know. And I know it sounds scary, but it can be exhilarating instead. The unknown can be just as exciting as it is fearful. Just let life happen and try to take it one day at a time. We fear loss of ourselves, of oneself. We fear loss of who we are and how we define ourselves, since it's a major component of our personalities. We're scared to lose who we think we are, because then we fall into a category of the unknown, and then we don't know who we are. And how do we know who anyone else is at that point? Think about it. It's important. In college, it happened to me. You face the fear when you enter college, and then again 4 years later when you go into graduate school, because you have to shift your entire way of life and thinking to adjust. And when it happens, you question, who am I really? People fear separation. No one wants to lose someone they care deeply for. We've all been separated from our loved ones from one reason or another. Remember the feeling when you were a kid lost in the mall, separated from mom? It happens. It causes a state of panic, a frantic state. Many people feel anxious even when they move to a new house, a new location, because they're leaving behind what they knew and setting themselves up for something unknown. Number four in the hit parade for fear, I'm surprised it's not higher on the list, is pain. Well, all we know about pain in terms of this component of it is it really hurts. Levels of pain vary, obviously, from situation to certain situations, but any circumstances, people really want to know, well, how bad? This is another fear that has to do with being in control, because humans believe that if they know what is in store, they can better prepare themselves. The problem with pain is that it often comes, as we know, unannounced, making it a fear that many of us face because it's going to come without us asking it to. We fear rejection, humans. Remember in elementary school when you put the note into the desk of the person you liked and that boy or girl didn't like you back? Feeling of rejection. As we grow older, we see more rejection and we feel it more. Think about it. We can't worry, because with age comes wisdom and maturity. Wisdom becomes understanding while rejection becomes prominent. Our way of dealing with rejection becomes better. We learn to take those no's with a grain of salt. So, out of all the fears, rejection may be one that can be controlled by how we react to it. People fear humiliation. No sane person wants to be laughed at, picked on, or the target of a joke. Humiliation is a huge fear for many, and comes in the form of public speaking. Many people get very anxious about talking in front of an audience. All eyes are on them. If anything goes wrong, there's one specific target, you. Best way to face humiliation is practice being confident. Fake it. Believe it or not, you'll make it. The more you command the room, the more people will listen to you instead of judge you. Sidebar, I had to speak in front of groups of people all my adult life for work. You have to make it like it's a football game, like it's a baseball game, like you're up at bat. and you're really going to swing for the home run and do the best you can. We fear disappointment. Disappointment comes in a couple forms. Form where you're disappointed in yourself, and another form where you're disappointed in others. We don't want to let people down, much less ourselves, but the reality is sometimes you can't please everyone. So we try to prioritize things. We try to breathe and realize that some things must come first over others. And you understand that we're going to succeed in certain things, but fail in others. You know why? Because it's okay. You know why? Because we're human. You know why? Because we're not supermen. We fear failure. A lot of us fear being bad at something. We all want to be the best at everything. Not in the cards. You can't do it like that. It's a yin and yang. Yin and a yang. You're good at some. You're not good at others. Maybe instead of fearing the failure, let it be a sign that there's something more to work for if it's something you're not doing well at. Think about it. If we were good at everything, what would be the point? Low on the list, but people fear death. A lot of people are scared of death. Because once again, the unknown, nobody knows what happens when we die. Religious standpoints, non-religious standpoints, death can be something to be scared of, right? Well, if you spend a lot of time worrying about how, where, or when we're going to die, not going to happen for a long time. So instead of spending our days fearing death, maybe we should put that energy into enjoying life. Because even though life is short, it's still days away before you see the end. The final fear to discuss today that people have in common is the fear of falling in love. Isn't that something? We fear falling in love because we feel the hurt. We feel the possible pain, rejection, humiliation, disappointment, and failure that can happen if it doesn't work. But you know what? All of the things we talked about as fears can be handled the same way in which we live. Cyclical living. Come up to the top of the Ferris wheel, you have two things. Hope and opportunity when you cross over. So, when you have your fingernails on the windowsill, and you're fearful of something, if you can get your fingernails on, you can get that fear taken care of. We have to have the proper attitude. Now, we move from our topic of the day to the action of the day. I happen to bring out what I call slab shatter. I contract with a grower for some specific things. I like indica, blah, 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 and different things. Okay. Well, you can see that it's come. Okay? So now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new thing called a fingertip dab by placing 1 gram of shatter, Gorilla Glue, number 4 shatter, on my finger. I'm now going to turn on the Honey Badger. Honey Badger is now rolling. Roll Honey Badger. Now, we're going to take the fingertip carefully of shatter and get it to the tip of the Honey Badger. Are you ready for our fingertip dab? Whoa. Holy cow. Holy Toledo. Oh my God. I might do a fingertip dab session. Not with a topic, just with a fingertip. Here we go. Well, needless to say, that was a super strong hit. And needless to say, thank you for watching The Senior Stoner. If you enjoyed today's video about what people fear and our fingertip dab, subscribe to my channel. Join the family. Please send me your comments, even about the fingertip dab, I love to reply to all of them. This has been The Real Senior Stoner, talking about what people fear the most. Cheers, everybody. Have a great day.